Plugin settings are the easiest and most efficient way to save data in a plugin. Today I'll be showing you how in the form of a nifty notepad plugin that saves what you write. Let's get started. Now the interface for this plugin is very simple. It's only a text box that fills up the entire widget with a 10 pixel margin on all sides. I have multi-line enabled and clear text on focus disabled. The font is code with size 18 and no placeholder text. The text itself is a prompt that I'll explain later. I also have text wrapped enabled and the alignment is set to the top left. So we'll go ahead and drop in a local script. We'll also drop the notepad itself in there. We'll go over the interface setup later, but for now we'll just reference the notepad object in the variables section. Now we'll create a function to save the text. So we'll create a function called DoneTyping. So as you can see from this page, the plugin object has a special function called setSetting. We'll be using this to save data. So we'll call plugin colon setSetting. Now inside these parentheses, we need to add a key and a value. Similar to data stores, the key is like a variable name and the value is, well, the value. So we'll name this setting notepad underscore and reference the game ID. This will ensure that the contents of the notepad will be different for every game you use it on. And for the value, we'll include notepad.text. And that's all it takes to save data, just one line. And now we can move on to getting the settings we set. And look, I misspelled plugin. We'll start by creating an empty string variable called saveText. And now down here in startup, we're going to add a while loop to wait until the game ID is not zero. Now, doing this helps account for two situations. The first situation is that the user hasn't published the game yet. This is a problem because if the game ID is zero for multiple offline places, our function up here will be overwriting that data. The second case is that sometimes the game ID just takes a little while to load. Now, this isn't too big of an issue, but if we try to get the text too early when the game ID is still zero, we'll fetch the wrong data. So in this while loop, all we really have to do is wait, say 0.3 seconds, and we can actually consolidate this into just one line. After game ID has been set, set save text to another function of plugin. This function is called, you guessed it, getSetting, and it only takes a string for the key. So we'll set this variable equal to plugin colon getSetting, and we can just copy this text up here. And look, I made the same mistake again. That's why you proofread. Now there's a case we haven't thought of yet. What if this place has never been opened before? What if there aren't any nodes to see? Well, in that case, we need to have something to default back to. GetSetting will return nil if there's nothing there, so we can just expect it and type or empty quotes. This acts as a kind of default value. Now that we've got the saved text, we can set the notepad text equal to saved text. So now let's finish up the interface. Up here at the top, we'll create a widget. We'll call it notepad and create a doc widget plugin thing and set the doc state to float. We want it to be initially visible. We want to override the previous setting since otherwise there's no way to open it. We want the initial size to be 300 by 200 and we want the minimum size to be 150 by 100. These are arbitrary numbers. You can make it pretty much whatever you want. Now back down here in startup, we'll set notepad.parent equal to the interface and we'll set the interface.title equal to notepad. Finally, in triggers, we're going to make this save function work. There's a property of text boxes called focus loss, and we'll be using that. Now, as soon as the user clicks on anything other than the text box, it'll save. So now we have a fully functioning plugin. I'll publish this and be right back. And now we're back in. If you have sharp eyes, you may have noticed that our warning took a little bit of time to disappear. That's just the game ID taking some time to load. So now let's test this. We'll deselect it, close it out, and then close out a studio. I'll be right back. And now that we've loaded it once again, our text remains. Now there is one thing to note. When you're developing a plugin, you're most likely going to make mistakes. And when you want to clear saved data because it's corrupted or something, there's a way to do that. We'll go up here into the plugins tab and open the plugins folder right here. It'll open this folder, although, wait, where are all the plugins? There's like two here, and I have like 30. Well, that's because you have to go back to Roblox and go into installed plugins. And this is where the plugins are. Now, they're all just IDs, so it's a little hard to tell what's what, but you can just sort by date modified, and then open the one you know that was recently changed. Now, there's this RBXM file up here, which you can drag back into Studio. And see, it's another copy of this exact plugin. It's a great way to, like, fork off of other people's plugins, or maybe learn how they made theirs, but please don't just re-upload them. That's just wrong. What I wanted to show is this settings.json file, and this is the data that is saved in raw format. So if I wanted to erase our data, I can just delete this settings file, close this, close out of Studio, and it's gone right back to being a blank slate. There are all kinds of advantages to using plugin settings, and I highly suggest you do so.